Waldron, Arkansas tonight, where the Boonville Bearcats take on the Waldron Bulldogs. Tonight's contest is almost similar weather-wise to what it was last week when we played the Paris Eagles. Boonville's coming into the game 3-0 tonight. And after wins over Joe T and Mina, and the 42-0 win over Paris last Friday night. Waldron's coming into the game 2-1, and with wins over Perryville, Bavaca, and a loss, heartbreaking loss last week to Dardanelle. Waldron won the toss and deferred, and Boonville went ahead and accepted the ball here. So we have Matt Schott back, number 10, and Blake Scoggins back, number 10, and Alan Ray. Trey Holloway takes the kickoff, fake handoff, gives to Matt Schott. Matt Schott goes wide. He makes a cut. He's back up to 35, back to 36-yard line. And that's how we start this ball game tonight. Boonville takes over at the 36-yard line.
There to make the tackle, Casey Lunsford, number 7, the quarterback for the Bulldogs.
Number 7, Casey Lunsford, from the tackle for the Waldron Bulldogs. I think he's the quarterback for the Waldron Bulldogs.
Great night for football, and the coach.
Great night. Just like last Friday night, a little bit hot, but I tell you what, it's a great night for football. Clear skies. We have Will Switt split to the left for the Bearcats and a double wing set. We've been in all season long. Gator Ray's a fullback. Brandon Rowe looks over the defense. Scoggins goes in motion. Isolation play to the right side. Alan Ray, I don't think he got anything. I'll tell you, that was a big defensive stop there by the Waldron Bulldogs.
You think they've been watching film on Alan Ray all week?
Well, I've been watching film on Alan Ray all week. With me tonight is Ricky Lee. I'm glad to have him with me tonight. Coach Reese is out scouting tonight, and glad to have Ricky Lee with me tonight. He's filming and also doing my color tonight. And Tom McCone's filming as well, and we appreciate these guys. Matt Schott's put to the right. Double wing set again. Brandon Rowland's on the defense. Zach Adair goes in motion. Rowland on the veer, picks up and keeps the ball. He picks up about possibly 2 yards, 3 yards. Looks like it's going to be about what, third and four?
About third and four.
Brennan Rowe is at quarterback tonight for the Boonville Bearcats.
Third down conversions are very important, aren't they, Coach?
Very important right here. Third down, this is a big play right here for the Boonville Bearcats on their first drive. Double wing set, we have split left. Hand off to Zach Adair. Zach Adair's got a seam. He cuts, makes another good cut. And a great run by Zach Adair. Good blocking that time, wasn't it, Ricky?
He sure was. Some great blocking there on the corner. Zach's really come on these last couple of games.
That's a great run. He comes up, Ricky, limping a little bit. That's not a good sign already on the first drive. He's a tough young man. I think he'll stay in there.
I think he'll shake it off. That's a quick young man.
Very, very quick. You're right. I tell you what, the Boonville offense trying to get it set for it. Tommy Glover's at center. Chad Ferris at the guard spot. Josh Morris at the other guard. Jordan Prey at a tackle. Blake Travis at a tackle. Matt Bishop at the end. And a double wing set again. Matt Schott split to the left. Scoggins goes in motion. We fumble the ball. Rowland picks it up. It goes right up the middle. He breaks it. He's going to go all the way. Touchdown, Boonville. Looked like a fumble there. And he regains control of it on the veer and heads right up the middle, Ricky.
Yes, great run. Way to capitalize even off a mistake.
Well, I was a little worried. I saw the ball pop out, but Brandon Rowland, quick hands, grabbed a hold of it, took off up the middle, right through the Waldron defense, and down. He scores on a long run. Alan Ray's getting his kicking tee back on. You can see we have some posts here in the way at Waldron, and the view's blocked a little bit. We apologize for that. There's nothing we can do about it.
That's exactly right.
Brandon Rowland's going to hold.
Alan hadn't missed one all year, has he, Coach?
Hadn't missed a time. That's great. I tell you, Alan's a real accurate kicker. Can do a lot of things. Snaps there, ball's up, and it's good. Alan Ray is perfect. It's 7-0 Boonville. 10 minutes and 5 seconds to go in the first quarter. First drive, Boonville takes it down the field and scores. We'll take a timeout. Back here at Waldron, Arkansas, the Boonville Bearcats lead 7-0. 10 minutes and 5 seconds to go in the first quarter. We have Russell Garrison's kicking off for the Bearcats again tonight.
Great drive to begin the game, isn't it, Coach?
You betcha. Great way to start the game. I tell you, Russell Garrison did a great job last week. He hadn't been kicking the first couple of games, and last week he took over the kicking duties where Alan Ray could get in the game quicker. And here's a boot. It's a pretty high, but a short kick down about the 15-yard line. And goes around the left end, number 36. He goes around the, and good return. That's a good return for the Waldron Bulldogs. Great return.
Brought the crowd right back into the game.
Exactly. He ran to the Waldron sideline here, and a great, great run there.
Well, last week we had a tremendous defensive effort. Hope we can get that same kind of effort tonight.
Exactly. I'll tell you what, the Waldron's already starting out with a better field position than Parrish had most of the night. We have Casey Lunsford, number 7, the quarterback. Dusty Lovett, number 32, is a fullback. And number 22, Tony Carnes, is a tailback. Hand off to the tailback, a little blast play to the right. Tony Carnes is wrapped up there. Looked like number 40, Josh Draper, come up to make the tackle along with several other Bearcats.
That defensive line surge has been impressive the last couple of games.
Very impressive. I tell you what, that defense is getting after it. They have really improved it's been, you know, the fourth game they've played. Great improvement on defense. Number 26, Bynum, splits left. They have a high backfield. Lunsford hands off, number 22, Carnes again. And Carnes gets maybe a couple of yards. Carnes a good running back. He rushed over 1,000 yards last year for the Waldron Bulldogs and has some speed. He's also a trackster and has some speed. If he gets in the open, we could have some trouble tonight.
We got to have those safeties and those cornerbacks coming up to force those plays on the corner. They did a good job that time.
Louisville's in their normal 5-2 defense. Looks like the backs are split this time for the Waldron Bulldogs. Lunsford drops back to pass. He looks. He throws an out pattern over, and it's dropped by the wideout. I'll tell you what, that was right in his hands, wasn't it, Ricky?
Yeah, it looked like a great pass. Just dropped it.
And looks like the Waldron Bulldogs going to be forced to punt.
Good defensive stand to begin the game.
Well, again, the Boonville defense didn't give up many yards there and still doing a great job. We have back deep for the Bearcats, number 12, Brandon Rowland, and number 2, Will Swint. Will Swint did a great job last week returning punts for the Boonville Bearcats, and hopefully he'll do a great job tonight. Snap back to Lunsford. Lunsford is also the quarterback as well as the punter, it looks like. The punt's fairly deep. Swint fakes a handoff to Brandon Rowland, goes left, and he's got a seam. Great return there.
Just one more guy to get by.
One more player and he'd been gone. I tell you, that was a good return though. Fake handoff to Brandon Rowland and Will Swint kept the ball around the left side.
Great field position to begin the second drive.
Tell you what, the last couple of games we've had good field position. Again, we start out with great field position on this drive.
Makes all the difference in the world too.
Brant Bishop splits left for the Bearcats as we get in our standard double wing set. Allen Ray, the fullback. Blake Scoggin, a halfback. Zach Ader, the other halfback. Rolling hands off to Allen Ray. Allen Ray picks up all, looks like about 4 yards.
You may shut him down for a little while, but he's going to get his yards before the end of the game.
You bet. The Gator's a tough young man. And he keeps those legs going. Good leg drive. Great running back. Just a junior. He'll be back for another year. Matt Schott brings the play in for the Boonville Bearcats. It splits left. And her double wing set. And we'll try here just a few minutes to get you the Bearcats' offensive line. Rolling hands off. Fakes hands off to Allen Ray. Pitch back to Zach Ader. Zach Ader on the option. And good gain again for Zach. Zach gets down to the 25-yard line.
That was a good job by Roland to pull that ball out of the middle. It was a good fake. And then when he came off on the corner, good pitch. Good job by Zach running down the sideline.
Great play by the Boonville Bearcats. Brandon Roland does a great job at quarterback. I'll tell you what, he reads the defense real well. Made a great decision there. Will Swint brings the play in for the Boonville Bearcats. And splits right. Tell you what, Boonville's offensive line's coming off the ball, Ricky.
Yes, they are.
Double wing set again. Zach Ader goes in motion, isolation play to the left, Allen Ray, and he picks up about 5 yards.
He keep pounding them in the middle, then that outside becomes open a lot better.
Right. Try to get the offensive line for the Boonville Bearcats. We have Tommy Glover at center tonight for the Boonville Bearcats. We have Josh Borsma at guard, Chad Ferris at guard, Blake Travis at tackle, Jordan Perea at left tackle, Matt Bishop at end, split ends Matt Schott, and I've given you the backs already. We have this time we have Brant Bishop split left for the Boonville Bearcats. Scoggin goes in motion. We have a quarterback keeper there over on the left side, and Roland picks up the first down.
I haven't seen that play. Was that a new play, or was that just
Yes, it's a play that they run off of. It's what it called is a keep, a quarterback keep off that, and actually he reads that as well. Does a good job.
Good play for a very mobile quarterback.
Great blocking by our offensive line that time. You can see we had a hole there, and great job on the offensive line. Scoggin goes in motion, and we have a flag on the play.
Looks like some motion.
Right, illegal motion on Boonville. So that's going to back us up 5 yards. It's going to be first and 15. 5 yards.
I've been impressed this year. We've been relatively mistake-free.
Very few flags so far. You're right, very few flags. I think it's something that's pleased Coach Rippey, too. Coach Rippey is kind of worried going in this game because of the big week we had last week with Paris. 42-0, big emotional win. And this is something he was kind of worried about going to this game, but looks like the Boonville Bearcats are up to play again tonight. Brandon Rowland, quarterback, looks over the defense. Scoggin goes in motion left. Brandon runs a veer, slips, falls, and is tackled over there with just a short gain on the play.
That's unfortunate. He had some yardage there if he hadn't lost his footing.
Right, went to plant his left foot. Looks like he slipped on the turf, and you're right, he may have got 4 or 5 more yards at least. It's second and 15 for the Bearcats. Matt Schott split wide to the right. Double wing set. Brandon Rowland looks over the defense. Takes a snap. Drops back to pass. Looks deep. And he's out of the end zone, I think. Ricky, he was open just for a moment there. Pretty good defense by the Waldron Bulldogs. He's open just for a second, but I think when he was open, he was out of the end zone.
I couldn't tell, Coach. It's a telephone pole between me and the play.
Yeah, it's we don't have a real good view here. It's kind of dark. We, you know, it's hard to tell the number of the players we have in our program. So bear with us tonight, people in Waldron, Arkansas. It's going to be tough for us, but we're going to bring you the game tonight. Split left is Brant Bishop. Double wing set again. We have third and long for the Bearcats. Hand off to Zach A. There he goes. Round, he's going to score again, brother.
He's gone.
He's in the end zone. Zach A. There. Oh, and we got a flag again. We've got a flag, and looks like we may have holding on the Bearcats. We do. It's holding on the Bearcats. We already was third and long. That's going to back us up a lot there. I tell
yeah,
you what.
That hurts.
That's a play. Was that the same play we scored on earlier?
Looks like it.
Looked like the same play we scored on the first time. Come back with that. Kenneth Rippey finds something that's working, and I tell you what, he sticks with it. Does a great job. But
Major.
Now the Bearcats are put in a terrible position here.
Yeah, from a touchdown back to a long third down effort. That was a big penalty.
Third and 25 for the Bearcats, and Matt Schott's pit right. We'll see what tricks Kenneth Rippey's got up his sleeve here on a third and 25. 4:51 left in the first quarter. Zach Ader goes in motion. Roland drops back to pass. He goes deep. Matt Schott's open. Great catch by Matt Schott. Touchdown, Boonville.
Great
pass. Great catch by Matt Schott. Actually, the pass
Fantastic.
Was a little over him. He adjusted to the ball tremendously well there. Matt Schott is a great receiver. I tell you what, great size, great speed. And here we see a pass laid up there. Brandon Rowland did a great job. You know, third and 25, they're looking pass anyway. And he laid it right in his hands. That was a great pass, great catch.
Well, Matt's really been an asset to us off of that split end this year, giving us a great threat.
Boonville goes up 13-0, 4:39 left in the first quarter. Brandon Rowland to hold. Dustin Andrews is our deep snapper here. And here's a snap, the hold, and Gator puts it through there. Makes it 14-0. The Boonville Bearcats, 4:39 left in the first quarter, 14-0 Boonville. We'll take a break. In Arkansas, the score 14-0 Boonville. I'll tell you tonight, if the video looks a little shaky, we're in kind of a shaky press box tonight.
And a tight space,
so,
too, so if I block
like
the
I said,
camera.
Bear with us tonight as we film this football game. Russell Garrison to kick off for the Bearcats, and here's the kick. It kicks over to the Waldron right side, down about the 15-yard line. And Bearcats looking to cover. And brings him down about the 20-yard line. Number 55, Chad Ferris on the tackle.
A little better coverage on that kickoff that time.
That was Eddie Spence on the return for the Waldron Bulldogs.
John Chase, Travis Hader, along with Chad Ferris.
Coach, looks like we had a good crowd came over from Boonville tonight.
Oh, great crowd this football game tonight. I tell you, I don't know if we have a biggest crowd as we did last Friday night, but I tell you what, it's a great crowd for football game. Kind of have an offset eye for the Waldron Bulldogs. Lunsford hands off to pitches to Carnes, and Carnes is brought down after a short gain on the sweep.
We've done a good job of forcing those corners so far.
Josh Draper made the stop for the Bearcats.
Josh Draper was on the tackle for the Boonville Bearcats. He didn't play last week. He's back this week and full steam, ready to go. We have split backfield for the Waldron Bulldogs. Lunsford runs a veer, looks like the split back veer, and is brought down, looks like by Tommy Glover, number 52 of the Bearcats. There's flags on the play, though. Let's see what's...
This looks like maybe we have some holding, Coach.
Holding on the Waldron Bulldogs. That's going to back them up. So I'll tell you, so far, Ricky, we've had a lot of penalties in this game.
Yeah, it's gotten a little sloppy here the last couple of series.
Offensive holding is going to be the call.
Set your Boonville defense right quick. We have Bubba Smith at nose guard. The tackles, we have Chad Ferris and Tony Shepard. The defensive ends are Jeremiah Dupree and Tommy Glover. Our linebackers are Josh Draper and Alan Ray. Our corners are Blake Scoggins and Matt Schott. Strong safety is Brandon Rowland, and our free safety is Zach Adair. And here comes the Waldron Bulldogs. I'll tell you what, they've got twins both sides here.
Looks like a passing formation.
Lunsford drops back. He throws outside and over Carnes. Carnes run a little out pattern there and threw it over Carnes' head. He was open there, and he would have had just probably a short gain, but overthrew him there.
Yes. I don't think that had a first down anyway, Coach.
So that brings up fourth down, and the Waldron Bulldogs again are forced to punt. Back for the Boonville Bearcats, we have Brennan Rowland and Will Swint, and Matt Schott's in the middle of the field. So hopefully we get a good return. We've had good field position. Again, we have a good chance of having good field position. Lunsford's back to punt for the Waldron Bulldogs. Here's a snap, low snap. Lunsford picks it up, gets off a good punt. Good punt. He turns it over. And hand off to Brandon Rowland this time. Will Swint, and there, I'll tell you what, Brandon did a good job just getting what he could get there. And we have a flag on the play.
Brandon's got some deceptive speed when he turns it on.
Right, he had four guys waiting on him there, and he made a little move and turned it on a little bit. We have holding on the Boonville Bearcats on the return, and that's going to, you know, instead of having great field position at the 50-yard line, Ricky, we're going to be backed up 15 more yards.
Inside the 40.
Or 10 yards. Looks like it's about the 38-yard line. Still, that's not too bad, Ricky.
No, that's a great place to start a drive. We hate to take that penalty, but we're still in good shape.
Will Swint that time, I think he may have been better off to keep it. I mean, he had an open field over there, but he did hand off, and Brandon Rowland just got what he could get there on that. We have Brant Bishop split right, double wing set again. Brandon Rowland looks over the defense. We have a hand back to number 23, Blake Scoggin. He makes a good cut, makes a good run, and he gets about 14 yards.
That's a great run, Coach. That looked like a little counter play, a little misdirection play.
May have been. Blake Scoggin did a great job there. And I'll tell you what, again, we had great blocking out of our offensive line. Well, he made a couple of moves in that run, Ricky, to give him some extra yardage.
Yes, he did. Broke a tackle or two.
Matt shots in. Always a threat when Matt's in the game to catch a long pass. He split left. Double wing set again for the Bearcats. Roland takes a snap, hands off to Zach Adair. That's a play we've scored on, and I'll be if we don't have a great gain again. All the way down to about the 23-yard line. A great run by Zach Adair.
Boy, showing some good speed. Good run.
You know, that play has been good for us already. We may be close to 100 yards on that one. Just on that one play, we ran it three times, I think, tonight.
But you start off the game, they run it up the middle, and make them conscious of that middle. And then we got a little, get them soft on the corners, and we're able to make some good yardage.
Right, I tell you, Zach's doing a great job tonight. He had a great game against Parrish, did a good job again tonight. Brandon Rowland looks over the defense. We have Will Swint split left. Scoggin goes in motion. Hand off to Allen Ray. Allen Ray up the middle, and Gator gets about a couple of yards. You know, one thing that impressed me about Zach Gator, he got in heavy traffic down as he's running. When he got in heavy traffic, you see him get both hands on the football. I mean, he was protecting that football.
And that's important in these games. Turnovers can turn the course of a game in a hurry.
Right, and we've been real fortunate so far this year, this being our fourth game, that we hadn't had that many fumbles.
The one MENA game was the one that we let loose of it too often.
Right. We have Brant Bishop split left. Double wing set. Allen Ray, fullback. Scoggin goes in motion left. Hand off to Allen Ray. And he's got a seam. He cuts back. And a good run by Allen Ray. I tell you, again, our offensive line has a hole there and Allen Ray hits a hole, goes right up the middle, and does a great job. He's down inside the 10-yard line. Looks like about the 5.
As an old lineman, I love to see those linemen blow them off the ball, and that's what you're seeing tonight as they're making some good blocks and opening the holes.
It's about a minute left in the first quarter, and it's 14-0. Boonville's driving. Boonville's on the 5-yard line. We have Matt Schott split right. Double wing set again for the Bearcats. Brandon Rowe looks over the defense. Hands off to Scoggin around the left side. Scoggin's hit there, and I don't know whether he may have got a yard. I'll tell you what, Waldron was ready for that play.
Yeah, they piled that up at the line of scrimmage.
That might have been the same play we've been running to the right. We run it back to the left that time.
I believe it's the one Scoggins had that long run just a little earlier.
Will Swint brings the play in for the Bearcats. About 30 seconds left in the first quarter. Will Swint splits right.
Official timeout.
Official timeout here.
It's like a little equipment problem for number 61 on Waldron's team.
I apologize for not getting names and numbers so much tonight, but it's hard to see. We're kind of in a dark area up here on the press box. Since the lighting is in front of us, I apologize for that. We have Will Swint split right. Double wing set for the Bearcats. Ball on about the 4-yard line. Hand off to Allen Ray up the middle. Allen Ray drives, and he gets close. He's in for the touchdown. Allen Ray, number 44, up the middle for the Bearcats, and he scores. And Boomer goes up 20-0 with 12 seconds to go in the first quarter. Of course, Allen Ray now, he has to
turn right around and kick, doesn't he?
You bet. Throw that shoe off and get his kicking shoe on, and I'm telling you what, he can get the shoe on in a hurry. And he gets his strap and laces his strap up. But he's gotten used to that.
Now I can identify with him. I both played the line and kicked when I was in high school.
Brandon Rowland holding. Here's a snap. Kicks up. And it is good.
Makes another one.
And Allen Ray makes the score. Boonville 21. Waldron 0. We'll be back in just a few minutes. And Carnes is back deep for the Waldron Bulldogs as Russell Garrison gets ready to kick off for the Bearcats. 12 seconds to go in the first quarter. Louisville, three touchdowns quick this first quarter. And here's the kick. Spence takes the ball on about the 10-yard line, goes up the middle, moves to the right a little bit. Number 86, that's McGrath. Mike McGrath on the tackle for the Bearcats.
That was good coverage by our kickoff team.
Right. The first time we kicked off, we kind of let them get a pretty long return there, and that time we did a good job. Lutsford comes onto the field for the Waldron Bulldogs. It sets their offense, gets them ready to go here. 4 seconds to go in the first quarter. Boone with a standard 5-2 defense. Waldron, it's like they're in a pro eye. Lutsford hands off to the fullback up the middle. And that's Lovett, number 32, for the Waldron Bulldogs. He picks up about 4 yards or 5 yards. And that's the end of the first quarter with a score. Boonville 21, Waldron 0. We'll take a timeout. Line of scrimmage looks over the defense. Hands off to Carnes. Carnes goes left. Breaks loose, and I'll tell you what, he's got some speed. Makes a good cut there. A long run. He's down to about the 40-yard line.
You can't take anything away from him on that run. We had him pinned up twice, both in the middle and around the corner, and he still got loose.
Exactly. I'll tell you what, showed good speed there, which we knew that coming into the game, that he had the capability. Ricky, if he gets in the open, he can hurt us.
We got to wrap him up.
Ball on the 40-yard line. And Waldron's putting together a little drive here. 11 minutes, 40 seconds to go in the half. Pro set again, pro eye. Lunsford looks over the defense. Runs the option here, gives it to Lovett. Lovett drives, and he picks up about 5 yards.
Over the right side, looks like Lovett picks up 5 yards on the carry.
A little triple option play there, Ricky.
Yeah, it was. Good run up the middle. That helps them when they get some yardage on first down, have a lot more options on the other two downs.
Dusty Lovett's just a sophomore for the Waldron Bulldog, but he runs hard. He runs hard. We have split backfield now this time for Waldron. Lunsford looks over the defense. Runs kind of like a split back veer again. Lunsford makes a few good moves there, I tell you. And that was a good run. He was dodging Bearcats all the way down through there.
And he made a good fake in the middle. Looks like most of our boys went for the fake and got on the fullback, and he kind of snuck through there.
Right. I tell you what, Waldron's putting together a pretty good drive here.
Combined for the tackle.
Oh, look like I got a face mask call.
Penalty called on the play.
Looks like we may have a timeout on the field. I see Coach Mann, the defensive coordinator for the Bearcats, coming onto the field. So I guess we have a timeout.
We got a timeout on the field.
On Boonville. And we'll take a timeout. We'll be back with you in just a few minutes. Waldron Bulldogs are putting together a good drive right here. Of course, Boonville had a face mask call here. That helped them quite a bit. They're on about the 20-yard line and driving here. Lunsford looks over the defense. Hand off to Carnes on the right side. Carnes runs into a whole host of Bearcats there. Looks like Alan Ray was there. Tony Shepard was there. Josh Draper, I tell you, a lot of the Bearcats were there on that play.
Makes a big difference when they can stuff them to just a few yards on first down.
Right. Ball looks like about on the 19-yard line, so they gained maybe a yard that time. Waldron goes back to the pro eye. Lunsford looks over the defense. Takes a snap. Hands off to Carnes on kind of a little draw-like play, sort of like a draw.
Draw or delay.
Yeah. And he didn't get anything. Matter of fact, he lost some yardage that time. Lost, what, about 3 yards?
Yeah, looks like about 3 yards on that play, leaving about a third and 11.
I tell you, after the timeout, Coach Mann made some adjustments here, I tell you, and they it's going to be third and 11.
Big down, momentum-wise.
This is a big play right here. Waldron's in a split back set here. Lunsford looks over the defense, drops back to pass, throws to the right, and Again, ball was dropped over on the right side there. I tell you,
I think it's a good pass. He's just not getting anybody to catch him.
Right. He looks good throwing the football. It's going to be fourth down and 11 here. Let's see what Waldron's going to do.
Looks like they're getting ready to go, Coach.
Fourth and 11, and Waldron's going to go for it here. And the Bearcats, looks like we have twins both sides here. I tell you, this is twins both ways. Lunsford looks, drops back to pass, and he's open across the middle. Touchdown, Waldron. Touchdown, Waldron. I'll tell you what, they had twins both ways, and he just run a simple post pattern, didn't he, Ricky?
Yeah, and he came across that middle wide open, and they nailed him.
I don't know what coverage was in that time, but I could see that he was going to be open, and he got behind. It looked like Brendan Rowland was covering on that play, and he laid it right in there. He bobbled a little bit, grabbed a hold of it, and that's 6 points for the Waldron Bulldogs. So with 9 minutes, 22 seconds to go in at half, Waldron strikes. It's 21-6. Here's a snap. The kick is up.
Oh, it's going to be blocked.
And who was that? Chad Ferris?
Looks like Chad
Ferris, number 55, coming to block that extra point. And I know it's early in the game, but you can't never tell. That may be a big play for the Boonville Bearcats there. We'll take a timeout and be back with you in just a few minutes. Spitz to kick off of the Waldron Bulldogs with 9 minutes, 22 seconds to go in the half. Eddie Spitz kick goes fairly deep. Back to Matt Schott. Matt Schott takes it to Trey Holloway. Fakes the handoff. Goes up the middle. And gains a few yards there. Brings it out to about the 25-yard line where a whole host of Waldron Bulldogs brings him down.
We're giving him a little momentum. It's time to take it back.
You bet. I tell you what, Waldron is fired up. The fans are fired up, and they're ready to go. This is going to be a big series here, Ricky. If the Bearcats can take it down the field and get a drive together here and score, maybe it'll get the momentum back our way.
Right. Take the fans out of the ball game and give us the momentum back.
Will Swint split right for the Bearcats. Brandon Rowland looks over the defense. Snap. Hand off to Blake Scoggin going left. Blake breaks through and gets about five, maybe 6 yards for the Bearcats.
Good yardage for a first down play.
Bearcats have been successful on the first down tonight, and that helps. And you get 5 or 6 yards on first down. Boy, I tell you now, second down, and Waldron don't know what we're going to do here. You know, we may pass, run. It's hard. You know, you got second and five. Double wing set. Matt Schott split to the right. Zach Adair goes in motion. Brandon Rowland drops back. He's open, and the pass is deep. And Matt Schott makes a great catch down the sidelines, and the Bearcats are going to score. We have a flag on the field. We have a flag on the field.
Great pass, great catch.
We have holding on the Bearcats, and that play is going to be brought back. A beautiful play by the Bearcats. Great pass, great catch right down the sidelines. It's going to be brought back, holding on the Bearcats.
It's been a frequent call tonight, hasn't it, Coach?
I tell you what, this has been a sloppy first half, Ricky, as far as penalties go. That was a great play. I don't know if somebody just tried to grab a hold of somebody to keep from hitting Rowland. I didn't see anybody pressuring him that much, but I guess we were guilty of holding that time.
Boy, a big penalty.
So that backs us up. Oh, man, looks like what, second and 25 there, Ricky?
Second and 25.
Brent Bishop's pit to the right. Double wing set again for the Bearcats. Zach Adair goes in motion. Brandon Rowland runs a veer, and he's got some room. He cuts. And I'll tell you what, if he could have got by one more person there, he'd been off to the races.
And they caught his path off for the pitch, or we'd had a good pitch on the corner.
But. Right. So the option play gets us some yardage back, and it's going to be about third and seven, looks like, for the Bearcats. Will Swint brings a play in for the Bearcats, third and seven. So Bearcats are trying to keep this drive alive. This is a big drive for us, momentum-wise.
Big play, big play.
Will Swint splits left for the Bearcats. Double wing set. Brennan looks over the defense. Motion by Scoggin. Hand off to Allen Ray, and he's going to be close to the first down. I can't
tell
right here.
It's going to be just a bit short, Coach.
Just a little bit short, you think?
Oh, we got
the first down.
Good
that's,
job.
That's a big first down. Boy, we got it. We just barely got it, didn't we?
Jared Christman along with Chris Hines making the tackle. First and 10, Bearcats.
They run the old veer then, and Brandon Rowland side, he read the defense, kept it with the fullback, gave it to the fullback, and Allen Ray kept those legs going and got the first down. Matt Schott split to the left. Double wing set for the Bearcats. Brandon Rowland looks over the defense. Hand off to Zach Adair going right, and he's loose again. He's loose again. He's turning it on. And number 36, Eddie Spitz, makes a great play over there on the
great
tackle.
Great run. Great run.
To stop a touchdown. I'm sure that Zach Adair's probably over 100 yards for the game already. Don't you imagine, Ricky?
I think so. He shook up a little bit on this play. We hope there's nothing serious there.
Eddie Spitz made a touchdown-saving tackle that time for the Waldron Bulldogs. Will Swint split to the left. As Brandon Rowland comes to the line of scrimmage, looks over the defense. A little pass, looked like a little tight end dump that time to Matt Bishop, and looked like it was deflected.
Good idea on the play, we just didn't get it executed.
I think number 22, Travis Adair, is into the ball game for Boonville, taking his cousin's place, Zach Adair.
Well, he did a great job on special teams last week. He was really getting down the field and making some hits.
Right. I'll tell you what. He did a great job in their JV game over at Charleston the other night. Double wing set. The Bearcats. Brandon Rowland runs the veer. Pitches over to Blake Scoggin. Blake Scoggin is tackled over here about the 28-yard line.
That was a great read by Brandon Rowland.
Looks like it'll be about third and four for the Bearcats. 6 minutes and 18 seconds to go in the half. The Bearcats are driving here.
Slow, methodical drive, just what we needed at this time.
Kind of put these Waldron Bulldog fans to sleep over here. Hopefully we'll stick in the end zone. Matt Schott split wide to the right for the Bearcats. Double wing set again. Zach Adair goes in motion. Hand off to Allen Ray. Allen Ray may get a yard, maybe two. That was running the old veer again, wasn't it?
It sure was. Big decision here for Coach Rippey.
Big decision. Right. It's going to be about fourth down and
maybe about three.
Yeah, fourth down about 3 yards for the Bearcats. And Coach Rippey's fixing to bring a play into the game. No. Waldron's called a timeout here. So we'll take a break here. We'll be back with you in about 60 seconds. To go in the first half, and the score is 21-6, and Boonville's driving here. It's been a long
big,
drive.
Big play, Coach. Big play. Fourth down.
We've got Will Swint split to the left. Double wing formation for the Bearcats again. Scoggin goes in motion. Rowland keeps the ball. Goes up the middle.
First down.
An inadvertent whistle there. They thought that Allen Ray had the ball. This has happened before for the Bearcats. And they thought that Allen Ray had the ball. They blew the ball dead up there. But Brandon Rowland had the ball.
First down.
Over, and Brandon does such a great job. And a lot of times they can't tell who has the football. That time we tricked the officials, didn't we, Ricky?
Yeah, we sure did. But I'm glad they gave us the spot that we deserve because we had that Brandon Rowland took it around corner, got our first down. Big play for us. If we can move it on in, we change this momentum completely around.
Had been, I'll tell you what, the Bearcat fans may have been out on the field there if they brought
right.
That play back. But we have Matt Schott split right for the Bearcats, double eye, a double wing formation. Rowland's drop backs to pass. He hits, who is that, Scoggin? Looks like he hits Blake Scoggin out there in the flats.
And, I believe that is Blake.
Pass is complete for about 5 yards, so first down we come out throwing.
Waldron has a player down on the field. Looks like maybe a leg cramp.
Well,
the passes we've hit this year have really opened up our offense and given us an opportunity to take advantage of a few more things.
But an injured player for the Waldron Bulldogs, Jimmy Russell, number 11, was injured on. He's the linebacker for the Waldron Bulldogs, and
we hope he's okay.
You bet. We hope he's okay. Looks like he may be a leg or knee. Ankle or knee. Second down and five for the Bearcats. Double wing formation. Wilson went split wide to the right. Hand off to, looks like Scoggin. And
good run, Coach.
Yeah. Blake Scoggin, right.
He'll be right out of first down, it looks like. First down.
First down inside the, 10-yard line, about the 8-yard line, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
First and goal for the Bearcats. 4 minutes and 14 seconds to go in the half. Bearcats have had the ball over 4 minutes in this drive. And this is what we needed. Double wing set. Matt shot. Split left. Here's the option play, give to the fullback, and he's down pretty close to the goal line.
Yeah, it's inside the five, maybe around the 3 or 4 yard line.
DeVere's been good to us tonight. I tell you, we've got some yardage off of it. And second to go, and ball on about the 3 yard line. Brant Bishop split wide to the left. Double wing set again for the Bearcats. Brandon Rowland looks over the defense. Hand off to Allen Ray. He's in for the touchdown.
Touchdown. Coach, that's the kind of drive we needed. Slow, methodical, take the time off the clock, drive it in, take the fans right out of the ball game. What a good series.
That makes the score 27-6. Boonville and Allen Ray's getting the shoe ready to try to make it 28 for the Bearcats. Ricky's right. I tell you, that drive, long drive, and Waldron was really fired up after they scored, and fans were really vocal, and this kind of quietened everybody. And that's what the Bearcats needed. Here's a snap. It's down. Allen Ray's kick is up, and it is good.
Still
and the
perfect.
Boonville Bearcats lead the Waldron Bulldogs 28-6, and we'll be back with you in just a few minutes. At Waldron, Arkansas, well, the Bearcats are leading 28-6, and Eddie Spence was checking up on that play for the Waldron Bulldogs, and he's coming off. Hopefully he's okay. It's two players they've had that's been shaking up, and I hope they're okay.
We had a roughing the kicker on the extra point, giving us an opportunity to kick closer up, Coach.
There's Russell Garrison kicking deep, and he kicks this one in the end zone, almost out of the end zone. So Russell teeing the ball up on Waldron's 45-yard line.
Kicked it out of the end zone,
and Waldron will get the ball on the 20-yard line. A little bit about this series between the Waldron Bulldogs and the Boonville Bearcats. Boonville leads the all-time series. 43 wins and 16 wins by Waldron, and they had four ties. Boonville won last year 35-6. Boonville has won the last three meetings. The first meeting was in 1931, won by Boonville 31-6 in that contest. So this is an old series as well. Like last week we talked about Parrish, and this is an old series as well. Lunsford drops back, hand off to Carnes up the middle. Kind of a delay there. And he picks up maybe a couple of yards.
And we stacked it up in the middle good by the interior line.
Bearcats coming into this game ranked number 2 in the state and one poll, and also ranked number 3 in another. So the Bearcats ranked high in the state rankings this week.
The way they played, they showed that they deserve that ranking.
Last week, a big win over Parrish, 42-0, and that was one of the best games I've ever witnessed in Boonville, Arkansas, since I've been here my 7 years at Boonville. And here we have twins both ways. This is the set they scored off of a while ago, Ricky. And there's a flag on the play. Looks like it's going to be possibly delay a game.
Must be. The clock says 0.
Second and six, and then, boy, that's a big penalty there, delay of game, if that's what it is. No, it looks like he's.
Well, it looks like he's talking to the. He's giving him a timeout.
It looks like maybe they got a timeout before the clock, before the play clock got to zero, and so.
Must have. They had the flag pulled out, but one of the other referees must have seen someone call timeout before the clock ran out.
All right, let's take a look at Waldron, Arkansas. And again, we see the same set there before the timeout. Twins both ways. Lunsford drops back to pass. An out pattern to Carnes. Carnes catches the ball and is knocked out of bounds. Looks like about at the 32-yard line.
Close to a first down. And they did get a first down.
First down for the Waldron Bulldogs. I tell you what, that's the first, I think, one of the first out patterns they've caught tonight. And the quarterback, Lunsford, has been on the money on several of them. They just dropped them.
And they've caught the last few, though.
Carnes moved out of his running back position and moved out and was a wide out there and went out and run a little out pattern, and Lunsford laid it right in his hands. Cut up the field and got the first down for the Waldron Bulldogs. Again, we see the same set. Twins both sides. Lunsford drops back, going deep, and that's incomplete. Blake Scoggin was covering on that play.
He was right there. It was good coverage.
That pass was intended for Dusty Bynum, and Blake Scoggin played the pass real well and wasn't a real well-thrown ball that time, and falls incomplete. Second and 10 for the Waldron Bulldogs. 1 minute, 54 seconds left in the half. Boonville leads 28-6. Again, we see Twins both ways. Lunsford drops back to pass. Going across the middle. Carnes, great catch in the middle of the field. And Brandon Rowland makes a stop on about the 48-yard line of the Boonville Bearcats. So Waldron is in Boonville territory.
Looks like a drag pattern right across the middle. Good throw, good catch.
Right, I tell you what, one thing that kind of surprised me, Ricky, is that he's having a little time to throw.
Yeah, we got to get some more pressure on him.
Our line right now, defensive line, you know, the other night when Parrish did try to attempt passes, we were on him. I tell you tonight, Lunsford's getting time to throw. Again, we see the same set, Twins both sides, single back. Lunsford drops back to pass. Again, it's complete. A little wide out that time, a little number 17 for the Waldron Bulldogs.
Looks like a short gain on the play. A little bit further than I thought, about 6 yards.
That was Bobby Brown for the Waldron Bulldogs making the catch. Minute 29 seconds left in the half. And Waldron is going to the air right here. And their two-minute offense looks like. Again, we have Twins, both sides, single back. Lunsford looks over the defense of the Bearcats. Hand off, it's time to Lovett, the fullback. Lovett's up the middle. Lovett drives, he's going, he's still going. That's a great run by Lovett. He is down about the 5-yard line. Ricky, that was a great run by Lovett. That time a single back, and took the hand off at right the middle, and our middle was wide open that time.
It was a great call. We've been spreading the field, waiting for a pass. They hit us right up the middle, a great run. He didn't give up, he kept running.
First and goal.
We need to stiffen up here with this last minute and 15 seconds.
Right. And we hear the Waldron crowd starting to get a little more vocal now. They're back to the pro eye set. Lunsford looks over the defense. Toss pitch to Carnes. Carnes cuts back. He's going. Looks like he's going to score. He's in for the touchdown. So Waldron scores here. I tell you what, this was they scored in a hurry. Several pass plays. The handoff to the fullback up the middle. And a toss. Sweep to Carnes right here, and Waldron is back in the football game, Ricky.
Yeah, this ball game's not over yet. We got to keep trying.
That makes the score Boonville 28, Waldron 12, and looks like they're going to go for two here. 1 minute remaining exactly in the first half, and we have a split backfield, double splits wide. Lunsford drops back to pass. Throws a slant pattern, and it's incomplete, and the Boonville Bearcats stop the two-point conversion. And with 1 minute remaining in the first half, Waldron has scored again. And the score is Booneville 28, Waldron 12. We'll be back in just a few minutes. Dusty Lovett's going to kick off the Waldron Bulldogs this time, and kick is on the way. It's a short kick, and it looks like Josh Draper takes the handoff, and he breaks a tackle or two, and a great hit right there at about the 48-yard line, and Waldron is fired up right now.
Yeah, we brought the fans back into the game, but we got good field position.
Right, and we can score in a hurry, Ricky.
We need to right here if we can.
28-12, Booneville leads, 54 seconds left in the first half. And I'll bet you Ken Rippey wants to get six more before halftime. Will Swint brings the play in, and he splits left. Boy, we have Carnes looks like is real deep. I mean, at free safety, he is there, and they're thinking we're going to throw the football. Blake Scoggin goes in motion, hand off to Zach Adair, and he tries to go wide, and he gets maybe about a couple of yards. And we have a timeout on the play. It's going to be, looks like, may have got a couple of yards. It's going to be about second and eight. And we have a timeout on the field, and we'll be back in a few minutes. Back at Waldron, Arkansas, 45 seconds to go in the first half, and Booneville's got a second down, 8 yards to go. Matt Schott split wide to the left. Hand off again to Zach Adair going right. He breaks away, and he's got the first down, Ricky. Looks like he's got the first down. The clock is stopped with 37 seconds to go in the first half.
I think it only stops until they set the chains. First down. Our guys are getting ready to get on the ball so they can move right ahead.
Right. As soon as they set the ball down, and then and they'll mark it there, and he'll start the clock. There he goes. Matt Schott split wide to the right. Adair goes in motion right. Rowland's going deep. Schott. Schott catches the ball. He catches the ball, but they say he's out of bounds, Ricky. That's a great catch. Matt Schott used his height that time. Went up over Lunsford, made a great catch, but he was out of bounds.
It's a late call on that one, Coach.
I'll tell you what, didn't look like the officials got in real good position that time. I'm not being critical, but didn't look like they got in real good position that time. Right?
He had to make up his mind. You could tell that it was a late call.
23 seconds to go in the first half. And
if we can just get a few more yards, one weapon we haven't seen this year, but I know that we have, Alan Ray can kick a field goal.
Alan Ray, I know out here before the game started, and warm-ups was kicking around 40-yard field goals, so, you know, he's capable of doing that. Double wing set. Will Swint split wide to the left. Rowland drops back to pass again. Going deep. And he was open. We just overthrew him a little bit. Travis Adair, number 22, was wide open. I don't know what happened on the coverage there, but he was wide open, and like Brandon just overthrew him a little bit.
Yeah, looks like maybe they threw it over he turned the wrong shoulder, didn't it?
Right. I tell you what, that was that fade pattern there is a tough pass to throw. It's a safe pass most of the time, but that time he just overthrew him a little bit.
Third down, Coach, 16 seconds. We need to get a few yards on this.
16 seconds left, double wing set. Matt Schott put wide to the right again. Travis Adair goes in motion. Uh-oh, Rowland's in trouble. He breaks out. He can run with the football. Now, I tell you, he makes a move there. He gets by. He is down to about the 26-yard line. We have 7 seconds left on the clock.
Be interesting to see what we do
and,
here.
Waldron has a player down right now, so the clock's going to stop. Waldron has an injured player. Number 55, he's trying to get off the sideline here. And Booneville calls timeout. So with 7 seconds left in the first half, and the ball was on about the 28-yard line, we'll take a timeout and be back with you in just a few minutes. 7 seconds left in the first half, and we have this is probably maybe the last play of the half. And
looks like time for that old Hail Mary.
Will Swint split wide to the left. A double wing set. Travis Adair and Blake Scoggin are halfbacks. Rowland Fakes a handoff, drops back to pass, rolls up into pocket. I tell you, he's got some room. He may score. He's got the 10, the 5. Touchdown, Louisville. Can you believe that, Ricky? No flags on the field. Brandon Rowland comes out of the pocket, flushed out of the pocket, rolls to the left, and scores on a good running play by Brandon Rowland.
What a way to end the half.
And that's, I'll tell you what, that was a great run by Rowland. Flushed out of the park. I can't believe that. I'll tell you what, 28-yard line. And he was almost sacked back there. Made a good move to get away from one defender. Took off down the left sideline. Made a good move about the 5-yard line and got into the end zone. That shows the athletic ability of Brandon Rowland right there, I tell you.
Great effort.
Looks like Louisville's going to go for two here. Willis went, split wide to the left. Double wing set again. Scoggin in motion, handoff to Allen Ray, and I don't think he got it. No, he stopped a little bit short. So the half's going to end there with Boomer, 34, Walden 12, and halftime at Walden, Arkansas. And Walden will receive starting the second half. Carnes is back deep for the Walden Bulldogs. Looks like along with number, I can't get his number there. Ricky, can you get it? 33, is that right?
Looks like 33 and 26.
33 is John Wesley. And 36 is, I think, is...
That's 26, I believe, Coach.
Okay. And Russell Garrison kicks the ball off. It's going deep. Wesley takes the ball about the 10-yard line, moves up to about the 20, and he is down about the 21 or 22-yard line.
Flag on the play, Coach. Looks like a face mask call.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's a face mask call against the Bearcats, looks like. Well, I'll tell you what, we have really had the penalties tonight, Ricky.
Yes, we have. A little uncharacteristic tonight.
Right. I'm glad to have Ricky Lee with me tonight. He's filming and also doing the color commentary, and I really appreciate him. Tom McCone is on the camera tonight, too, as well, and I appreciate both of these guys for helping me tonight.
Glad to do it, Coach.
Just a 5-yard penalty on the Bearcats.
Big Lunsford series
comes
of downs.
Line of scrimmage. I thought, Ricky, we might see this more. It's a twin set both ways for the Walden Bulldogs. Single back. Lunsford drops back to pass. A little slant. Oh, boy, I tell you what, we're fortunate there. Number one, the ball hit his hand, and Scott Dean, and he dropped the pass, Ricky.
We call that in technical terms a drop.
Exactly. I tell you, he had some running room, too. Looked like a little slant pattern there, and then the ball was right on the money. I tell you what, Lunsford, I'm really impressed with Lunsford, his passing ability. Tonight, he's been on the money most of the time.
He threaded that needle that time. That was a good throw.
Waldron had some success the first half, into the first half, passing the ball, and we see him come out this time in a pro eye set. Carnes is back deep, toss, pitch to Carnes. Carnes moves to the left. It picks up about 5 yards there for the Walden Bulldog.
Big play here for momentum, Coach. First drive of the second half, we can shut them down here. It would do a great deal for helping us to regain this momentum and drive forward for another touchdown.
Right. Second half is just underway. Waldron faced with a third down and 5 here. Pro eye set again. Lunsford looks over the defense for Waldron. Takes the handoff, toss sweep to Carnes on the right side. Carnes keeps driving, and I tell you what, Ricky, he's going to be awful close to the first down.
That was a good run. He got hit early, but he kept driving those legs and made a good 4 or 5 yards. Looks like they may have to measure.
It looks, I'll tell you what, Ricky, it looks like they may have it here, but it's hard to tell.
It is hard to tell, but it looks like the sticks are just inside the 40-yard marker there, and that's exactly where the football lies. So it's going to be within a few inches.
10 minutes and 56 seconds to go in the third quarter.
Yeah. By about a half a football, Coach, they got a first down.
So it's a first down, Waldron. So Waldron on the first drive picks up the first down, and this is a big drive for Waldron, and if the Bearcats can stop them here, and keep the momentum. We scored right at the end of the last play of the half. Brandon Rowland scored on a pass play, broke away, and receivers were covered and flushed out of the pocket and scored. Lutzford hands off to Lovett up the middle. Lovett gets about a couple of yards. Lovett's just a sophomore. He runs hard for a sophomore, Ricky.
Oh, he sure does. Sophomores, after he gets a little experience, he ought to be able to really do some good things for Waldron.
Waldron breaks their huddle, comes out. Boomer in their 5-2 defense. Split backfield for the Waldron Bulldogs. Might be a pass situation here. No, they run to Veer. And Lunsford picks up maybe a couple of yards. Looks like it's going to be about third and five.
Again, we come to that big third down.
They were successful last time on third down. They had a toss sweep to Carnes, toss pitch to Carnes on the sweep, and he picked up the necessary yardage. And I wouldn't be surprised, Ricky, if they don't go back to it here. Split backfield. Waldron likes to pass out of this situation, and Lunsford drops back to pass. Little out pattern to number one, and depends on where the ball is marked.
Looks like they got it again, Coach.
I think you're right, Ricky. Looks like he has the first down. So Waldron, I tell you what, they're a slow drive here, but they're, it's 9 minutes and 29 seconds to go in the third quarter, and
they keep moving those sticks right now.
You bet. And as long as they can do that, they feel like they're still in the ball game. Have pro eye set here. Lovett to fullback, Carnes to tailback. Hand off to Carnes to the left side. Carnes looks like Tony Shepherd come up and made him cut there a little bit and brought him down.
Got good penetration, didn't he, Coach?
Right, good penetration by Tony Shepherd. Tony Shepherd plays with a lot of emotion out there on the field. He's one of our defensive leaders, and Tony's trying to get this defense fired up for the Bearcats. Coach Ken Rippey was worried coming to this game. I said it earlier about the emotion. Last week was such a big game, such a big rivalry, and tonight we were concerned about the Bearcats coming in and playing with intensity. Lunsford drops back to pass again, out pattern, and I tell you what, he is stuck there by Blake Scoggin.
That's
Blake
a good
Scoggin,
hit.
Right, he made him pay for it. It's a good catch, though. Good catch by number 17 for the Waldron Bulldogs. That's Bobby Brown. He's a senior. That was a good catch, good throw.
It's like about a five-yard gain.
It's going to be third and five for the Waldron Bulldogs. I tell you what, they've been in this third and five, I think the last
two or three times.
Two or three times, right. Again, we have a split backfield on third down. Lunsford looks over the defense, directs his backs back there. Hand off to Lovett. Lovett drives, and Lovett's going to be, again, Ricky, awful close to the first down.
Lovett on the carry, number 32.
Looks like with the mark, he'll have it again.
He does have a first down. So I tell you what, the Waldron Bulldogs are methodically moving the ball down the field against the Booneville Bearcats. And, they're using a lot of clock here. They're down, quite a few points, but they're using the clock. And but if they can punch it in right here, they feel like they're still in the ball game. Lunsford hands off to Lovett, and Lovett gets a couple of yards before he's met by Josh Draper and Tony Shepherd again.
Well, it's like the same play. They got the big gain just before the end of the first half, but our interior line was ready for it that time. He didn't get but about a yard.
Number 26, Dusty Bynum, brings the play in for the Waldron Bulldogs, and he splits left. We have a pro eye set again for the Waldron Bulldogs. Lunsford toss pitch to Carnes. Carnes goes right and runs into a whole host of Boomer Bearcats. One is Josh Draper, and we have a flag on the play. Now, I don't know.
Yeah, it looks like he's looking at our side over here for a personal foul.
Yes.
Oh, face mask.
I tell you what, an official starts to mark the ball off the wrong way, and I can't, Coach Ken Rippey is just beside himself on the sideline. We've been flagged, I don't know how many times tonight, Ricky, but it's been an unreal amount.
That's right.
Again, a face mask, an inverted face mask, 5-yard penalty, but that gives him a second and five. And Waldron is still driving. Hand off to Carnes. He goes left. He's got some speed. He, I tell you what, Josh Draper made a great play that time.
Cut him off on the corner. That was he took the right angle and made a good play.
Right. I tell you, Carnes has some speed. Matter of fact, he is one of the fastest backs probably in our conference, if not the fastest. And Josh Draper just did a good job bringing him down there.
It looked like he had the corner, but he cut him off and held him to just about a yard or two gain.
6:23 left in the third quarter. Waldron driving. Split backfield for the Waldron Bulldogs. Third down and 4 yards to go for the first down. Hand off to Lovett up the middle, and he breaks through, and he's still going. He makes a good cut there. Roland grabs a hold on. Brandon Roland brings him down. It looks like about the 15-yard line.
You can't take anything away from him on that run. That was just sheer determination. He just kept them legs churning. And we're going to have to wrap up that young man because he's a hard runner.
I'll tell you what, he is just a sophomore, too. He's impressive as a sophomore. I've been impressed with their quarterback, Lunsford, tonight, and also their fullback, Lovett. I'll tell you what, they and Carnes, of course, is a good back. So, and we have timeout on the field at Waldron, Arkansas. The Boonville Bearcats leading 34-12, and Waldron driving. We'll be back in a few minutes. Waldron, Arkansas, 6 minutes and 5 seconds to go in the third quarter. Waldron's driving. First down and 10 from about the 15-yard line. Lunsford looks over the defense, drops back to pass, throws a fade pass to number 17. Touchdown, Waldron. I tell you what, Waldron may have got away with an offensive pass interference there, don't you think, Ricky?
I sure do, Coach. It looked like he was juggling the ball. I guess he got under possession before he went out of bounds over there, but that was a good pass.
I tell you what, that was a good catch. I thought he'd possibly pushed off a little bit. It's Blake Scoggin. Of course, it's kind of hard to tell at our angle, but Waldron does score, and the score now is 34-18 Boonville. I tell you, Waldron is not quitting. That was a great drive for them.
It was a great drive. They're still in this ball game. They did use a lot of time on the clock, though.
Have twins both sides here. Lunsford quarterback, single back, drops back to pass again, throws across the middle, and incomplete there. Looked like it was to number one again, Scott Dean. Good coverage that time. But I tell you what, he had a chance, I think, possibly to catch that one. Lunsford done a good job for the Waldron Bulldogs tonight. 5 minutes and 59 seconds to go in the third quarter of the score. Boonville 34, Waldron 18. We'll take a timeout. Waldron Bulldogs, we're back at Waldron, Arkansas. It was 6 minutes there. They took the ball down the field and scored on the Bearcats. And Lovett kicks off for the Waldron Bulldogs. Hand off to Trey Holloway. Hand off to Gator up the middle. And I tell you what, Gator's in the wide open field here. Makes a good cut. And is brought down on about the 45-yard line. At that time, our little handoff down on the kickoff paid off, Ricky.
It paid off, and it was some great blocking. They'd opened up a hole down through the middle. And Gatorade did a good job of taking the ball out to about midfield. And that gives us a good opportunity to start this drive.
We start this drive on just about the 44-yard line of the Waldron Bulldogs. And I tell you what, we need to take the ball down the field and score here. 34-18, Bearcats lead. Will Swint split wide to the left. Brandon Rowland looks over the defense of Waldron. Takes a snap. Hand off to Zach Adair around the right side. Zach has hit at the line of scrimmage but keeps driving. There's another flag, two flags. I tell you what, there's some... That's a tough run for Zach.
Yes, he did a good job of keeping his legs moving. Be interesting to see. Face mask on Waldron, it looks like.
Well, today we've had a lot of face mask calls tonight. This time it's against Waldron. 5 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the third quarter. That's going to almost give us a first down. I tell you what, awful close.
Still first down and just a couple of yards here.
Right. Good time to pass, wouldn't you think, Ricky?
Big good opportunity, Coach. We'll see what
Brandon Bishop split wide to the left, and Scoggin goes in motion. Brandon Rowland runs the veer, cuts up field, gets away from one defender, and is tackled by a whole host of Waldron Bulldogs, but not before he got, looks like about 15 yards there.
Late flag on the play. Great run by Brandon. It was a good fake out there on the outside. He cut it up, made a great run. Looks like an unsportsmanlike conduct on the Boonville Bearcats.
Unsportsmanlike conduct on the Boonville Bearcats. Boy, I hate to see that, Ricky. That was a good run by Brandon Rowland, but it's going to be brought back. And I don't know what happened. Did you see the play?
It looked like one of our players went by the referee on the way back and said something. I don't know what he said, but it looked like that's what initiated the flag.
Penalty moves the ball back to the 48-yard line.
Oh, that's a tough penalty right there.
Nullifies a great run by Brandon. You hate to see that.
Right. Still first down and 10. The ball on the 48-yard line of the Waldron Bulldogs. So the Louisville Bearcats are driving. Double wing set again. Wolf went split wide to the left. Dustin Andrews in motion. Gator Ray drives and picks up about 7, possibly 8 yards.
Good strong run right up the middle.
Dustin Andrews is into the game at halfback, comes in for Blake Scoggin. And Scoggin returns to the game now, along with Matt Schott. Zach Adair is limping a little bit. He goes off the field, Ricky.
We need him.
Matt Schott split wide to the right. Double wing formation for the Bearcats. Brandon Rowland audibles at the line of scrimmage, it looks like, sounds like. Hands off to Alan Ray, and he cuts back. I tell you what, he may score right here. We got, he makes a move, gets by ahead. I tell you what, that was Carnes possibly saved a touchdown there.
You got to be impressed with the way Brandon keeps his head in the game and when he faces adversity. He doesn't just cave in. He looks for an opportunity to make something out of nothing. He did a great job of turning that play back around, taking it around in, and making many yards there.
He sure did. 4 minutes to go in the third quarter, and the Bearcats are driving.
And we're chewing up that clock. That's what looks good here, too.
Brent Bishop split wide to the right for the Bearcats. Double wing. Travis Adair's into the ball game for the Bearcats. Hand off to Scoggin going wide, and he is brought down for a loss there.
We allowed too much penetration that time and forcing the play deep and costing us a loss on the play.
Jonathan Shockley coming up that time and made a great play for the Waldron Bulldogs. We didn't fool anybody with that play, Ricky, that time. I tell you, that's good penetration by the defensive line of the Waldron Bulldogs.
Yes, they did that time.
Will Swint split wide to the right. Double wing formation for the Bearcats. I tell you what, they've got a lot of people up here close to the line of scrimmage now. And Travis Adair in motion. Hand off to Alan Ray. Alan Ray, good tough run there. And he got, looks like about 8 yards. And got a lot of that back.
With several guys riding his back. He just made a great run, strong run.
We've got third down and 6 for the Boonville Bearcats as they drive down the field against the Waldron Bulldogs. Matt Schott is split wide to the left. Double wing formation for the Bearcats. Scoggin goes in motion. The veer, Brandon Rowland fakes a fullback, keeps it, and fumbles the football. And
looks like
the Bearcats guy is back on the ball. Looks like that's Matt Bishop that got on the football for the Bearcats. So, and Brandon Rowland is down. He's a tough young man as well. He gets up.
We're all glad to see that.
You bet. Brandon Rowland is a tough young man. I tell you what, he's a great football player, great competitor. He's not a real big kid, but I tell you what, he is super tough.
Got a big heart for this game.
The
ball's on the 9-yard line. The Bearcats are driving first and goal here as the Bearcats try to punch this one in. About 2 minutes to go in the third quarter. Travis A. there in motion, isolation play to the left. And Allen Ray gets a few yards there. Looks like maybe down to about the 5-yard line. So it's going to be second and goal, I guess, from about the 5-yard line. A minute 40 left in the third quarter. Anthony Davis comes in for the Boonville Bearcats. Looks like we're going to have a double tight set here. We have no split in on this play. Double wing set, though. Scoggin goes in motion. And Roland keeps. And didn't get a whole lot there. I got kind of blocked that time, Ricky, by the pole, and I couldn't see what they were running that time.
Well, it looked like just the veer over to this side, Coach. They forced the play in a hurry.
No gain on the play. Third and goal.
So it's third and goal from about the 5-yard line for the Bearcats. The Bearcats need to stick this one in. We've been averaging 42 points a game, and so we score here. And happen to get the two-point conversion, that'll be our average. Fumble, snap. Brandon Rowland, I don't know what happened on the exchange there. Didn't get the ball, and it's going to be fourth down.
Fortunate to get back on that ball.
That's two fumbles this drive that we've had that we've been able to get back on the ball. Very fortunate. Looks like Dustin Andrews is coming onto the field, so it looks like we may try a field goal here. Dustin Andrews is our deep snapper. And looks like we have the field goal team coming on.
Looks like we called a timeout to set this up, but it looks like that's probably what we're going to do.
Right.
We sure have the potential with Allen Ray.
We'll take a timeout here. Waldron Arkins with the score. Boonville 34, Waldron 18.
Getting his kick and shoe ready, and Boonville Bearcats are going to attempt the field goal here. The ball's on about the 5-yard line.
I think this is a good thing, Coach, for Allen Ray to get some experience back here kicking some field goals. We may need this later on in the year in a big way.
22 seconds left in the third quarter. There's a snap. Ball's down. Kick is up. And then
26-23.
Looks like it was wide to the left. The official said it was wide to the left. And so his attempt fails for the field goal here, and so the score remains. Boonville 34, Waldron 18. We'll be back in just a few minutes.
Dr. Boyer, you need to report.
Back at Waldron, Arkansas, and Waldron takes over on their 20-yard line here. Twins both ways. Lunsford drops back to pass. He's pressured a little bit. And the ball's intercepted by Trey Holloway. Trey Holloway intercepts the pass. He drives good blocking for him here. And Trey Holloway takes the ball down to about the 15-yard line of the Boonville Bearcats.
What a great interception. He reached up, grabbed it with that one hand, pulled it in. Great interception.
I didn't even realize, Ricky, that Trey was even in the game that time. And I guess he came in to spell somebody on defense and was just happened to be in a good position there. Did a good job.
Made the most of his opportunity to get in there. That was a great interception and a great run with the interception once he got it. And it was a big time for us. With the missed field goal, we kind of gave them some optimism. Now we kind of quieting the crowd down again.
Back at Waldron, Arkansas, and after the interception, Trey Holloway interception, we have the ball back. Ricky, where's the ball? About the 18-yard line, 17?
That looks about right, Coach.
About 6 seconds to go in the third quarter. Brandon Rowland under center hands off to Allen Ray. Allen Ray drives, and he didn't get maybe possibly a yard.
I know you're hesitant to do so, Coach, but let me mention to everybody that was your son, Trey Holloway, that made a great interception on that play.
Yeah, I kind of gave him a hard time last week. I'm glad to see him make a good play. Made a good run, so I'm glad to see that. If that's the end of the third quarter with the score, the Boonville Bearcats 34, the Waldron Bulldogs 18. We'll be back in 1 minute. Last night, the Boonville Bear Kittens defeated the Waldron Bulldogs 28-0 at Boonville last night. And we didn't play 7th grade. We're playing 7th grade Jamboree over at Waldron tomorrow morning. So the 7th grade didn't play last night, just the junior high. The Boonville Bearcats are driving here. 2nd and 9. And Brandon Rowland looks over the defense of the Waldron Bulldogs. Double wing set, double tight. Hand off to Zach Adair. Zach Adair has a seam. Zach Adair, he's going to score. Number 24, Zach Adair. Good blocking by our offensive line that time, Ricky.
Great blocking. Great run. Went for daylight, took it all the way in.
Zach Adair, I tell you what, he's had a night, hadn't he?
He sure has. All of our boys have played well.
Zach Adair's not a big young man, but I tell you what, he runs tough. He's quick, has good moves, and doing a good job. Looks like we're going to go for two here. We get our two-point conversion. We're averaging 42 points a game, and looks like we're going for two here. Brennan looks over the defense, double wing set. Scoggin goes in motion left. Hand off to Allen Ray. Allen Ray, he gets the two-point conversion, and the Bearcats lead the Waldron Bulldogs 42-18. And we'll take a break and be right back. Burns and Wesley are back deep for the Waldron Bulldogs as Russell Garrison tees the ball up for the Boonville Bearcats. Outside of one kickoff tonight, the Boonville Bearcats kickoff team has been effective.
I sure have, Coach. And that's important.
This is a big part of the game, special teams. Russell Garrison kicks the ball very high and down to about the 20-yard line, not real deep. And I tell you what, another bone-crushing tackle by Chad Ferris. I tell you what, last week he made a great block, and this week he come down and he, man, that was a...
And the ball was on the ground, but Waldron got back on it. Number 32, 22.
Number 22, Carnes fell on the ball. Number 55, I tell you what, Chad Ferris. Ricky, he's a tough football player.
He is a tough ball player and a fine young man as well.
11:46 remaining in the fourth quarter, 42-18. Lunsford looks over the Boonville defense. Boonville got twin set over here on the left side. Lunsford toss, looked like a quick pitch to the Carnes, number 22, and he stopped with very little gain. Well, Ricky, we may have been fortunate that time. They had twin set here on the left, and we only had one defensive back out there with them.
I was really surprised to see them going the other direction on that play. They must not have noticed that we didn't adjust to that too quickly.
They may try to do something here off of it and see if we adjust.
Hopefully we'll be ready this time.
We have split both ways, flanker to the right, split into the left. Split backfield. Lunsford rolls to the left, throws. Fullback out in the flats, number 32, Lovett, and the throw was a little low that time, and Lovett couldn't handle it, but he was open.
Yes, he was.
That was a little fullback waggle out in the flats, looked like, and the throw just a little low, he couldn't handle it, and that brings up a third down at about 11 for the Waldron Bulldogs. Boonville brought a great fan support tonight. I tell you, there's a lot of people on the track over here. Our fans are, our stands are full on the visiting side. And so great support from the Bearcat fans again tonight, Ricky.
They support our team well.
Twin set both ways. Pass over the middle, and it's short. A deep post there. We have a flag on the field.
Looks like a flag on the play, Coach. I don't know what they call. We finally got some good pressure on the quarterback. That's what I thought they were calling, roughing the passer. It looked to me like it was about on time, but to the referee's eyes, it looked like it was a late hit.
So Boonville has a roughing the passer call, and boy, that's gonna that would have been fourth down. That's gonna give him a first down, isn't it, Ricky?
Yeah, sure will.
Fifteen-yard penalty on the Boonville Bearcats, roughing the passer, and that gives the Waldron Bulldogs the first down, and the ball's on about the 39-yard line. So that keeps their drive alive. Pro eye set. Lunsford hands off to the fullback, Lovett. And Lovett gets about 6 yards there. Good, tough run by Lovett.
That is a tough runner, Coach.
Second and about 5 yards for the Waldron Bulldogs. Number 26, Bynum, split left. Flanker to the right. Lunsford, busted play, it looked like, and boy, I'll tell you what, Alan Ray and Tony Shepard, or no, that was Chad Ferris, they went after him.
They were right on top of him that time. Good penetration. And we made them pay for a busted play.
Lunsford kind of took the handoff and kind of stood there like somebody, one of the backs that may have possibly went the wrong way. And Alan Ray and Chad Ferris was on top of him. We have a timeout, Waldron, with 9 minutes and 39 seconds to go in the fourth quarter. Score Boonville 42, Waldron 18. We'll take a timeout.
Here you will find the most important people to us are our customers.
Our store hours are 8:30 to 6 o'clock on Monday through Friday and from 8:30 to 5 o'clock on Saturdays.
But we realize that your prescription needs don't stop at 6 o'clock p.m. We're available after hours with a phone call.
Are you tired of the long wait on third-party insurance prescriptions? We accept Medicaid, PCS, paid prescriptions, and others.
And guess what? We fill them now.
Try our drive-thru for your call-ins on prescriptions, or drop off your prescriptions while you're shopping Boonville.
We have the most complete line of special occasion cards in Boonville and have a lot of gift items and accessories such as Hallmark crystals, collectibles, and ornaments.
So come by and see Bill, Louise, Daisy, Linda, Christy, or Emily.
You may start out as a customer, but you will end up as a friend at Big World Pharmacy.
And time out on the field.
Coach, we again want to say to our fans, we're grateful for Channel 33 giving us this opportunity to film these games. Our press box is real shaky tonight, so that's the reason you may see some shaking in your picture.
We have a twins both ways for Lunsford as he drops back to pass out in the flats. And Zach
great
A there.
Great hit, Coach, causing him to drop the ball, making an incompletion.
Right. Carnes was open, as a good pass, and Zach Anderson made a good hit to break it up. And so the Waldron Bulldogs are forced to punt here with 9 minutes and 34 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Back deep for the Boonville Bearcats is Will Swent, number 2, and Brandon Rowland, number 12, along with Matt Schott, number 10. Lunsford's back to punt. You know, he's the quarterback, too, so, you know, he could pass the ball out of the situation.
Yeah, got to keep your eyes on
him. But he's going to punt. And Brandon Rowland gets away from the football, and, boy, it takes a Waldron roll down to about, the, looks like, the 13-yard line. So not real good field position for the Bearcats, but leading 42-18 You know, we can hold on the ball here and just run that clock out and get us another victory, Ricky.
Yes, sir, Coach. That's our objective at this point.
Again, I want to thank Ricky Lee for doing a color tonight as well as filming. I'll tell you what, he's a man of many talents. Have Tom McCone on the camera tonight doing a great job. And we thank both of these guys for helping me tonight. Jerry Standridge as well, he'll be playing the game back to you. And thank Jerry as well.
Well, Coach, I want to say I appreciate the coaching staff at Boonville. They do a good job of encouraging these young men. It makes a difference in their lives.
We have a double tight set here, double wing, single back, Alan Ray, rolling. We have, that looked like the Canadian Football League, didn't it, Ricky? We had both the wing backs going motion at the same time. And
it looks like some laundry out there on the field.
Right. Oh, a little boo-boo there by the Boonville Bearcats, but let's go and back us up a little bit. In the Canadian Football League, I guess you could send two people in motion at the same time, but in high school football, and you can't do that. So, motion on the Bearcats. So that's going to make it first down and 15 for the Bearcats.
5 yards, first and 15.
We'd like to get out from underneath the shadow of that goalpost.
Yeah, I'll tell you. 9 minutes remaining in the ball game. Brandon Rowland under center. Scoggin goes in motion. Renevere to the left. Rowland fumbles the football. And looks like Waldron may have it. It's hard to tell.
There's a big pile there. They're having to wait to see who comes out on the bottom.
And Waldron has the football. Looks like Brandon Rowland, I couldn't see anybody. Somebody may have possibly hit his hand. I couldn't tell from here.
I couldn't see it from here, Coach. Looks like he just lost the handle on it as he tried to break in the open there.
Brandon's usually pretty sure-handed, and that time he just slipped away from him. And Waldron takes over on their Bearcat 21-yard line. Pro eye set for the Waldron Bulldogs. Lunsford quarterback. Went all the way tonight for the Waldron Bulldogs. And again, we have flag on the field.
Look like motion over here on the left side of the Waldron Bulldog offense.
Right. And that'll be 5 yards against the Waldron Bulldogs. So it'll be first and 15 for Waldron. Our cheerleaders do a good job at Boonville also. Miss B does a great job, the cheerleaders. They keep her fans fired up.
Well, we're proud of all of those who take part in our athletic programs, from our cheerleaders to our band to our fans. We're
grateful. Pitched to Lunsford that time, and Brandon Rowland out of his strong safety position comes up to make the tackle for a big loss.
From having the ball on our 21, they're now almost back to about the 38-yard line, 37-yard line.
Of course, I mentioned head coach Ken Rippey, Dale Manager, defensive coordinator for the Boonville Bearcats, and we have Jim West, also assistant coach for the Bearcats. Kevin Tipton coaches the line. David Beckham, also assistant coach for the Bearcats. So these guys do a great job. Jimmy Reese is out scouting tonight with Darby Ulmer, and we appreciate the scouters. I tell you what, they go out, and a lot of times they're overlooked, but they do a good job for the Bearcats. Lunsford drops back to pass, and again, the whistle stops play, flag on the play. I tell you, we've had the flags tonight, Ricky.
Yes, we have. Looks like another illegal motion. They're going the wrong direction at this time, and we're grateful.
What is that, second and 30?
I can't add up that much, Coach.
We'll call it second and 30 from about the 41-yard line. Lunsford has twins both sides, single back. Lunsford drops back to pass, flushed out of the pocket, rolls to the left, tucks the ball away, and a whole host of Bearcats there to bring him to the ground. Looks like number 88, Jeremiah Dupree, 56, Tony Shepherd, number 40, Josh Draper, and 55, Chad Ferris were all over there on the tackle for the Bearcats. 7 minutes, 15 seconds to go in the ball game, and Boonville's leading 42-18.
Still third and 30.
Third down and 30 yards to go, I tell you. We have Lunsford at quarterback, drops back to pass, rolls to the right, looks deep. Looks to get out of the pocket, and he can't get away from number 52.
Coach, it looks like we made some good adjustments at halftime to try to get some pressure on that quarterback, and it's really paid off here in the second half.
Right. Tommy Glover, number 52 that time, come up and made a great play for the Bearcats. Lunsford rolled right, and Glover, good size, good speed, made a great play at defensive end for the Bearcats. We have a split. That's the second time, Ricky, that Waldron's had a busted play, and I don't know what happened. But
we were right there on top of it, though.
You bet.
Coach, to center for a loss and to take over possession of the ball. Now if we can just drive down the field and take care of business, we can wrap this game up.
Right. Looks like we have our second offense in the ball game. I'll try to get you some of those names. Boonville's second offense. Mitchell Widener, I think, is number 59, is the center for the second offense. Russell Andrews is a guard. Aubrey Borsma is a guard. Blake Harger and Jared Goddard, I think, are the tackles. Number 84, Anthony Davis, is also in the game. Trey Holloway's the quarterback. And then we run to Veer. And Trey picks up about 13 yards there on maybe that was a keep, 12 keep.
It looked like it was, it may have been a 12 keep, but he did fake it in the middle and then take off around the side there, and good run.
Dustin Andrews is in the game at one running back, and I'll check the other running backs here in just a second. Number 81, Russell Garrison, goes into the game at one tight end. Travis Adair is at one halfback. Dustin Andrews, another halfback. And John Chase, which just got the ball from Trey Holloway, the fullback, picks up maybe a yard. So it's good to see our second offense get to go into the game here with about 5 minutes to go. And this gives them some experience. A lot of these guys are sophomores and juniors, and gives them confidence, Ricky, as they go into the game.
You know, I believe last year we were a young team, and we're seeing the results of having our young team get some maturity last year. It's always good to see these second-teamers get an opportunity to get some experience and be ready for next year.
Mike McGrath is into the game at tight end, number 86. Trey Holloway takes a snap, hand off to John Chase up the middle. John spins, cuts, and a good run by John Chase as he picks up about 10 yards for the Bearcats. And we have a flag thrown on the sideline over here. Looks like it's thrown at. Coach Rippey is very upset on the sidelines. I don't know what the problem is. He is very upset with the officials at this time.
Yeah, it looks like that's about the second time the head referee has called some unsportsmanlike conduct on the Boonville Bearcat. The Boonville Bearcats fans are letting him know about it at this time.
I don't know what happened on the sideline, but it had to be something way away from the play. I don't know if something was said, but anyway, that's going to give us a second and 15. And double wing set. Trey Holloway gets up to the line, looks over the defense for the Bearcats. Andrews in motion, Handoff. No, Trey Holloway keeps and picks up maybe no gain for the Bearcats. Maybe picks up a yard. It'll be about third down and 14 yards for the Bearcats. Three minutes and 50 seconds left in the ball game. The Bearcats are really going to have to hurry if they get this play off, Ricky. It's down the play clock's down to about 5 seconds. It's going to be close.
But they did
it. We do get the play off.
Ball on the ground.
And ball's on the ground, and I couldn't tell what happened.
Looked like Justin Andrews got the recovery there, Coach. I didn't see how the ball got on the ground as well.
I think Trey Holloway got the snap, it looked like, but had penetration by the defensive line, looked like, and I couldn't tell exactly what happened. But anyway, the Bearcats are forced to punt here. Fourth down and about 20, and Matt Schott is in to punt for the Boonville Bearcats. Chrisman, number 25, is back to back deep for the Waldron Bulldogs. And Matt Schott gets a beauty off. Drives Chrisman back. It's about the goal line, and he breaks away from one tackler and is stopped down there by number five, Dustin Andrews, and number 80, I can't tell who that is, 88, Jeremiah Dupree. So Waldron takes over on about the 4 yard line. 2 minutes, 44 seconds to go in the ball game.
They have a long way to go to get them some points before the end of this ball game. It's like our second team defense as well in there, Coach, or a lot of our second team players.
First and 10 for the Bulldogs. Ball at the 5 yard line.
Lunsford hands off to Lovett, a fullback, and he gets a few yards there. I tell you what, Waldron's backed up here, you know, on the about the 5 yard line, so it's a dangerous place to be. Lovett, I've been impressed with him tonight. He gets a couple of tough yards, and it brings the ball out to about the 7 yard line, where it's going to be. About 2 minutes to go in the ball game, and Waldron has the football. Lunsford hands off again to Lovett up the middle, and Lovett picks up a few yards, tough yards.
Kind of surprised to see him running up the middle. There's just a few minutes left in the ball game.
Right, I tell you, it's about a minute and 40 seconds to go in the ball game, and it's been a good ball game tonight. I tell you, the Boonville Bearcats have, scored 42 points, they've scored 42 points in every game. And tonight they have scored 42 points again, holding Waldron to 18 points. Lunsford drops back, hands off to Carnes on a draw play, looked like, sprint draw. And he's tackled there, and we have another flag on the play.
Looks like another flag, maybe a face mask again. Oh, it looks like a holding on the Waldron Bulldogs.
So Waldron's assessed with the penalty here of holding. Minute 21 left in the ball game. As the officials talk to Alan Ray, the defensive captain of the Bearcats, as he decides what we need to do. And holding on the Waldron Bulldogs. It is declined. It will bring up fourth down and about 5 yards to go. So the Waldron Bulldogs are forced to punt with 1 minute and 21 seconds to go.
It don't look like we're even going to put anyone back, Coach. We're going to be making sure that they punt this ball.
Right. Even if we don't send anybody back, Ricky, we should still get good field position. And just a little over a minute left in the ball game, we decide to keep them from possibly getting the first down here on a fake. Lunsford's back. Of course, he's the quarterback as well. Always a threat to pass. Low snap. Does a good job of picking the ball up. And it's a wobbly punt that gets a good Waldron roll all the way down, it looks like, to about the 42-yard line. And there it's blown dead, and the Boonville Bearcats will take over on the 42-yard line. 51 seconds to go in the ball game, and we'll take a timeout. All right, back at Waldron, 51 seconds to go. Trey Holloway has the second offense in the ball game, and looks like he's just going to take a knee drop, Ricky. He does take a knee drop, and looks like about 40 seconds left. Clock's running, and we'll probably have to snap one more time, Ricky, and this ball game will be over.
Yeah, it looks like this will be the end of the ball game after this next play.
Well, Boonville Bearcats tonight, I tell you what, Coach Kenneth Rippey was really worried about him coming into the ball game after the emotional game last week, but I tell you what, they come out, and despite our penalties we had tonight, they played a good football game, Ricky.
Played a very good football game, and Coach Rippey has them really ready to play this year.
There's a snap. Trey Holloway goes down to his knee, and this football game is history from Waldron, Arkansas. The final score tonight, Boonville Bearcats 42, the Waldron Bulldogs 18. From Waldron, Arkansas, this is Gerald Holloway, Ricky Lee, and Tom McCone. And we thank Channel 33 for showing this game, and thank Jerry Standards for the Boonville Development
Committee. The BDC, the Boonville Development Corporation.
Thank you, Ricky. I got a little tongue-tied there. And we thank those guys, and we'll see you next week as it's homecoming at Boonville as we take on Dardanelle.